described in captioned media program. In the classroom and online, dcmp.org.
Human Relations Media presents Buzz in a Bottle, the dangers of caffeine-spiked energy drinks.
Show the demolished motorcycle and car. At a bonfire, partying kids drink from cans.
Blythe was friends with everybody. I mean, she was pretty popular.
She was one that was very fun to laugh with, laugh at.
A teenage girl with long brown hair smiles.
There was nothing wrong with her. They found no traces of any drugs of any kind. The only thing they found traces of was caffeine and taurine.
In a picture of her as a toddler, the girl gives a bright grin. As a teen, her picture appears by the words, "In loving memory." At a high school football practice, a player leans over, panting heavily.
I catch the ball on the 5-yard line, I'm running down the field, and then all the symptoms just come in a rush. I mean, headache, grogginess, blurred vision, shortness of breath, everything in just one big hit. It was scary. I kind of limped off the field and then just collapsed on the sideline.
A title, Buzz in a Bottle, the dangers of caffeine-spiked energy drinks. What are energy drinks? Dr. Richard Church, University of Massachusetts Medical and Health Center.
There's a vast array of different ingredients that are in energy drinks, including sugars such as fructose and sucrose, different B vitamins. Taurine is an essential amino acid. It's actually the most abundant amino acid in animals and in the human body.
T-A-U-R-I-N-E.
Just like any other amino acid, taurine is used to sort of help drive multiple different metabolic processes throughout the body.
Amino acids and the vitamins are things that you would get in a well-balanced diet. You don't need any extra in an energy drink in order to be healthy. Many of the products contain herbs.
Dr. Mary Claire O'Brien, Wake Forest University.
But there's not evidence to suggest there really are any. People believe it, but there's not evidence for that.
All things herbal and all things natural are not necessarily good.
Nutritionist Rovinia M. Brock, PhD.
Tobacco, all these things, the poppy, that from which heroin is made, all these things are natural, not good, however.
My experience with energy drinks started probably about a year ago. I don't know, it wasn't really anything like big, it was just kind of like one thing led to another and it just became like almost an addiction. I basically continued drinking them until I kind of felt my heart pounding during practice and stuff, and it like a shortness of breath, and like I would get constant headaches. And
student athlete John Bellow.
During practice, when I felt the symptoms, I never looked back and thought, oh, wow, that must be from the energy drinks.
Energy drinks also have a lot of other ingredients, such as caffeine and caffeine-containing ingredients.
Caffeine's been around since
seminar, alcohol, caffeine, and youth.
Since 350 AD in China. And 90% of the American population, including children, drink caffeine on a regular basis. Guarana is from the Amazon basin, and it is a berry. It's just another natural source of caffeine. This is one of the ways in which
The Described and Captioned Media Program provides services designed to benefit students who are blind, visually impaired, deaf, hard of hearing, and deaf-blind. These services include a library of free-loaned, described and captioned educational media, a clearinghouse of information related to educational media access, a gateway to internet resources related to accessibility, and a center for training and evaluation of any service provider desiring to appear on the DCMP's approved list of description and captioning service providers. There are no user registration or service fees. Visit the DCMP at dcmp.org. The DCMP is funded by the U.S. Department of Education and administered by the National Association of the Deaf.